soon fill it with petrol that's leaking. Oh, I wonder if it's the breather right at the very top. Oh, the gauge is working. I wonder if I dare take it for a run up the road. Certainly throaty. A gale through the tops of the doors. But it's doors locked. Checking round here. Not sure about that body. I think one he's filled it up, he's filled it right to the neck. Oh, it's got some pork. Oh, that's better than the 300 TDI. What's this bloody pensioner doing here? Clonk on the gearbox, I think it's the shaft, because it was slightly undersized. That's 120 on unbalanced wheels. That goes all right. Hey! Yeah, I've got to get wheels balanced. They're terrible. And I'm going to have to do a proper bonnet lock. I don't like that idea at all. I wonder how accurate this speedometer is. Mind you, it should be, because it came out of the original truck. Temperature gauge is over the top, but I'm not too worried about that because it's not reading right on the sensor. And also, this truck has no soundproofing in it. The only thing it's got is the tunnel cover. Third gear, pull away. That was 90. To inspect where that fuel is coming from. I've never filled the tank up before. In fact, that was the first time it's ever been on the road. Not been too bad. There. So the ultimate test, will it spin its wheels? Yes, it will spin its wheels. A four-wheel spin, nice. Right, let's get back. Well, fire's gone out. Oh, my throttle's stuck. Too keen. Again, I have to adjust. I have a lot of adjustments to do. That's alright. I was steering sounding a little bit, but other than that, I'll give it an 8 out of 10. There's some things we've got to look at.